Greetings and salutations, everybody. Hey, girl. Hey, we are back for another foundation review. It's been a few weeks. Can you believe it? I can for sure. Today, we're going to be talking about the new, infamous Pure Cosmetics 4-in-1 Love Your Selfie Liquid Foundation that comes in 100 shades. That's what's getting everyone's attention. The amount of shades that they decided to release is unheard of. Literally. Pause before we continue with this video. If you notice that my eyes are a little red, 2 days ago I tried out a new lash serum recommended to me by a lot of people and generally the person who does my lash lifts. As you can see, you can actually see my lashes a little bit today. I love the lash lift, but the serum that I decided to get off of everyone's recommendations did start staining my eyelids and discolor like my lower lash line this morning. My eyes were not good. They were bloodshot. They were swollen. Obviously, that's a negative reaction, etc., etc. I am not out of this world right now, nowhere near it. If you see some redness, there's nothing I can do about it. It's either I don't film today or I work with what I got. I did put a little bit of under eye concealer at the top because otherwise I just look like a zombie. If y'all haven't picked up this Flower Cosmetics concealer yet, generally all over your face, I could skip foundation with just this concealer, and it's available at Walmart. So what are you waiting for, fam? Going back to this foundation, this retails for $36, available on purecosmetics.com or Ulta Beauty. Pure has all 100 shades, while Ulta only has 40 shades available, and I don't think all 40 are available in store either. I'll put the number here, how many are available in store, because they just don't got that room. They weren't trying to give that room. As we talk about this, as you can see, I'm only holding one shade. Yeah, I only bought one shade. I know, the chances of me being wrong very high right now, but I wanted to pick a shade that is available at Ulta's website. I don't know if this is one of the ones available in store specifically. I feel like a lot of the mediums in the Ulta's 40 weren't available in store, but if it is, it'll be right here. If it isn't, it's also right here. This product is made in Korea, cruelty-free, gluten-free, and vegan friendly, it says on the website. I don't know what that means compared to saying the word vegan, but I'm assuming it's just vegan, but it's vegan friendly. Pure Cosmetics has been around since I started YouTube. I used to wear mineral foundation when I started YouTube, and their mineral foundation was what everyone loved back in the day. Foundation itself has a very unique packaging. It does have a pump, but it also has a doe foot applicator right here for spot concealing targeted areas, because it is the 4-in-1 Love Your Selfie long wear foundation and concealer. Not like it wasn't a long enough name, but it's like a dual purpose, kind of like the Clinique foundation that is also a 2-in-1. Pure Cosmetics does have an Instagram page and a page on their website that's supposed to kind of help find your shade. Didn't help at all for me. I put in different foundations that I already wear, and no matter what, it kept telling me I wore one of like the fairest shades in the whole line. I was like, there's no way. The description was like fairest pink. So it was not working for me no matter what foundation. Even though I changed the foundation shade to a darker shade, it kept telling me the same one. Not sure if that was a glitch. So I had to go off my gut, which isn't always correct, especially in this little summer transition we got going on. I'm not Photan Sam right now. I'm just whatever the world actually gave me. So I went with shade MG7, which is beige, described as a golden medium with golden undertones. This shade is the 37th shade out of 100. Might be a little dark though. It depends on how it sets. If it oxidizes at all, I'm gonna have to do quite a bit of highlighting and concealing. So as you can see, I've already pumped out a little bit. I am also going to try the doe foot applicator. They advise that you use a flat top as an applicator. They do sell one, and Ulta does have a sale where if you buy this foundation, you can buy the brush for $10. That's their little deal, their little bundle. I wasn't too off, honestly. I feel like the next golden shade above this was so far away. And I think this will work for me in the summertime after maybe like 2 more weeks. But that's not bad at all. Hopefully it stays like that. But wow, this is beautiful. Hello. The claims would be that it's a long wear, medium to full coverage foundation that has a lot of skin nourishing ingredients that is supposed to boost and rejuvenate your appearance, also protect against blue light and environmental stressors like pollution, and help refine texture and tone. Just check out this straight shot right now where this is before, more my problematic side, but hello. And after, I look smooth like a baby's bottom, but you can see where the color kind of ends a little bit. I do have a lighter center compared to my shoulders, and this is like a click, a minor click too golden at the moment, but this is gonna work for me in the summer. I know it's gonna work. So maybe I was just being proactive. I didn't really wanna buy my winter shade right now. Honestly, truly, this is something I kind of put a lot of faith into. But once everything else kind of highlight all that, I can pull it off for the moment, at least for this video. Let's try a sponge on this side. And I'm gonna take the remaining part of the dish. It blended so beautifully with a brush, so I don't doubt that it will blend beautifully with this velvet sponge, which is kind of like a spongy brush. Currently, I only have one major pimple on my face, but he's not too like swollen. I'm probably gonna do like monthly updates, and at the end of my 3 months on my acne meds, my Spiro as they call it, I will release that video, but I don't want to do like separate videos. I want to do just the, you know, ending review it all type of situation. Wow, this foundation is beautiful. I haven't been wearing a lot of foundation, but this makes me miss it. It's so smooth, guys. Oh my, coverage is booming, beautiful, breathtaking, all the bees. I'm gonna put a little bit on the side of my eyelid just because I don't want that like kind of line between where my foundation stops and my discoloration begins. If you decided to get a different shade for your concealer, I think the concealer doe foot concept or that targeted area would make sense. Or if the shade matched you so perfectly that you just wanted to spot conceal. Oh, that was too much there. I'm just gonna quickly conceal and add some brightness to my face. I absolutely love this finish. It's so nourishing. It's so healthy looking. Will it stand in this heat? Heck to the no. I'm gonna need some translucent powder. I don't wanna alter it too much. I'm definitely gonna put a good amount of translucent powder in my very oily areas, my T-zone, my nose strip. Otherwise, a light grazing of translucent powder with the big fluffy brush is all I'm gonna do. A little bit of cheek products, maybe a little lip balm, and that's it for today for me. I'm gonna finish up the rest of my face, give you guys some starting point pictures, and then I'll see you guys at the end of thy day, and we'll see how this foundation does. It is 1:20 in the morning right now. But here we are, 12 hours later. Yeah, I know I got a late start today, but still, it is what it is. Luckily, I have a late finish too. So we got a good amount of hours out of this foundation. Oh my, I just saw it for the first time. Overall, color-wise, I am pretty happy with my decision. I did have a moment during the day where I kind of regretted it. I saw myself in the car mirror and I saw myself with this shirt where it kind of covered my arms, and I was like, yeah, this journey is like a click too dark. But when I'm sitting here, it actually looks pretty good. And during like daylight, for the most part, it looks pretty good. It's that car mirror, because that thing gives a shadow already. It's not a good looking mirror, you know. It is definitely still a little too dark for this section of my body to be the only section showing. But between MG7 and MG6, either or I think would work for my twinsies, just depending on, you know, if you're buying for summer or if you're not. 12 hours is quite a long time, and this foundation is showing the wear of it now. I'm getting little like indentations, kind of little marks. If I touch here, you see little fingerprints and stuff like that. Impressionable, is that the word? Soft, you know what I mean? It's little lines. I don't know where the lines are from. Maybe I like scratched my nose or something like that. But for the most part, I would say 8 out of the 12 hours, I was pretty darn flawless. I was very happy with it. I wasn't seeing any issues, nothing to complain about. I think it just looks best up to maybe 10 hours. I think the last two probably pushed it a little bit. I'm not super greasy. My nose is not horribly greasy. It actually feels pretty good. It's definitely not oily, but it's barely tacky. I will say the sides of my nose, because I was running a little bit, you know, I was eating some crabs, my nose started running, the foundation definitely broke up around my nose. It definitely felt the wear and tear of like tissues kind of coming towards it. Cheeks are looking great. The powder sat pretty darn well the whole day with it. I think it's just becoming, you know, a little expired now. I'm not mad at how it sat in my pores. I'm not mad how it sat in my fine lines. I think it's definitely a creamier formula. You guys saw the finish. It's very, very healthy. I will address the 100 shades thing now after, you know, spending my day in this foundation. I don't think they needed 100. I don't love the fact that even though they made 100, 100 is only going to be available on their website. 40 is available at Ulta, and half of that's only available in store, you know what I mean? I think 40 to 50 was more reasonable. 100 just seems like overkill. And I don't have all of the foundations to swatch, or I can't tell you if the foundations actually do vary enough that it made sense. But just from an overall outsider's perspective, that's just my opinion. But at least the formula's bomb. And I guess it's better to complain that there's too much compared to not enough, right? So I'm not hating on it, Pure. I think you did an amazing job with this foundation concealer. I think the concept of the pump and the doe foot is very helpful for how nice and forgiving and smooth and blurring the formula really is. I think it's just a good foundation. I'm pretty happy with it. I don't think any of my foundations look like this in the bottle, at least even my summertime shades. So I feel like the foundation just looks darker in the frosted glass. I could be wrong, I could be going crazy. It just looks just a tad bit darker in here. Price is pretty reasonable. I think it lived up to its claims. My skin doesn't look like it's having any reaction. Overall, it definitely gets my stamp of approval. I will definitely use it again. It does say Pure Minerals is a company out of Atlanta, Georgia, but it is made in Korea. And then there's a few things that say something about London at the bottom. But overall, claps to you, Pure. I was shocked, and it was so lightweight that I forgot that I was wearing makeup. And when my husband got home from work, he didn't even realize I had makeup on. Go figure, even though, you know, men sometimes don't recognize it. Okay, so that's it for me, low energy Sam at 1 a.m. Thank you guys as always for watching. The Juvia's Place foundation is the next one up, and then we'll be talking about Maybelline's newest release after that. So I hope you guys get excited. Make sure you are subscribed if you haven't yet. Hit the notification if you don't want to miss any of my videos, and my other past uploads will be right there. Thank you guys as always for watching, and I'll see you guys in a later video.